A show of solidarity by candlelight,
justice!
On canvas, and in concert. 6,000 miles from the demonstrations and street protests in Tehran, activists and artists in New York City seemed to find their voice this week, as many inside Iran were quieted. Iranian-American Johnny Azari attended this vigil and planned his own late-night tribute.
The feeling of powerlessness really is just overwhelming.
What he could do was bring together several bands to raise awareness.
We wrote a song for the people of Iran.
Debuting an anthem about the Green Movement, the signature color of opposition leader Mir Hussein Mousavi. In the audience, his dad, Shoja Azari, an artist exiled from Iran in the early 80s. His work is part of a contemporary art exhibition which just opened at the Chelsea Art Museum. And it's truly contemporary, last updated at 2 a.m. the night before the show. It incorporates images from YouTube of the protests and violence in Iran.
Fortunately, the regime cannot really cut all the communication because of the technology and the internet.
From digital artwork to this on a drum, here Shiva Ahmadi paints her commentary on the political power of oil. In Iran, she was forced to self-censor.
It was very frustrating. You're an artist, you put your heart there, you're doing what you believe in, but then you never get to show them.
But here through September is the chance for 56 artists to show their work. 35 of them still live in Iran, where their art is considered subversive.
The main idea behind the show was to really defy stereotypical perceptions that the people have of a country like Iran.
Till Felroth is co-curator of this exhibit, originally planned to mark the 30th anniversary of the revolution in Iran.
None of us are able to go to Tehran right now and be on the street demonstrating, but I feel through our work what we can do here to raise awareness, provide a platform for people to speak out.
A platform and a voice that many inside Iran are still hoping to find. Seth Jones, CBS News, New York.